resume gaps, for example, due to time off. I've got one individual who chatted in that there's a 24-month gap in their resume. That, among other things, are sources of hang-ups for executives. We lose sleep over these things when we're seeking new positions. Do recruiters get as hung up on these things as we do? What's the truth around that?
We don't get anywhere near, well, let me be specific. I don't get anywhere near as hung up as many people do. There are others that do, and you don't want to work for that person. So again, I like transparency, I like confidence, and I think a lot of people really value being unsafe. This is another example of what I meant by be unsafe. I had a candidate that I was dying to interview a few weeks ago. He sent me his resume for a particular role I was working on. He had an 18-month battle with cancer, and it was on his resume. I'm not saying that's appropriate, not appropriate. I'm just saying that when I saw the fight he had to overcome and the strength and fortitude he had to go through that process and how transparent and confident he was, I couldn't wait to get him on the phone. Whereas if that resume just had an 18-month gap, the mind creates all kinds of explanations. What's with the 18-month gap? And I'm smart enough to do the math and figure out the gap. Everyone is. So when in doubt, I genuinely explain the gap. There shouldn't be long gaps because they should be filled with consulting or advising or working with nonprofits or whatever it may be. But if you stayed home to raise a kid, say it. I hire more moms than you can imagine. I'm on the board of a company where two-thirds of the leadership team are women, most of them moms. So raising kids, fighting cancer, traveling the world, going back to school, I think that the world has become a much more forgiving place for untraditional backgrounds. Trying to hide it or disguise it can be very frustrating because an employer might just say, screw it, I'm not going to spend the time guessing, and they move on to the next candidate.